Get ready to match the star. Dwayne Hickman. Brett Summers. Gary Burghoff. Carol Lawrence. Richard Dawson. And Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers.
All mussed up and the show's just beginning.
I was just aflame when I saw your vest.
Gene, what are those little things on there? Are those flowers?
One of my friends told me I died on a match game.
You're dying.
He's a man of extremes.
That's right. Okay. Those are, I don't know.
What are those?
Birds of paradise,
birds
I suppose. I don't know.
Maybe name the bird of paradise.
My wife got this for me for Christmas. Wasn't that nice of her?
Very
yeah,
lovely.
Thank you.
She must think
ask
you're
me
old.
What time it is, Richard.
What time is it, Jane?
Oh, half past kissing time. Time to kiss again.
11:32. Well, that's New York time.
Oh, of course it is. Yeah.
Isn't that pretty?
Lovely.
Beautiful, Jane.
Richard gave that to
actually,
me.
Actually, it plays a tune, doesn't it?
That's real gold, isn't it? There?
It plays a tune.
Nothing's too good for me. Thank you,
Richard. The theme song of the Third Reich.
You're nothing. Now, let's say hello to our current champion. Here is Jim Lawrence. How are you, Jim? How do you feel?
Good.
Jim, as time ran out last time, he had won a game. He's got his $100. Now he's going to have a go at over $5,000. How do you feel about that?
I'm ready.
Okay, we'll do it right after this message of interest to one and all gathered here on this day. Here we go with Jim Lawrence. Jim, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Young blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. Now, if you match the next one, you get $250, and the third, $100. Three celebrities are permitted to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Young?
Young at heart.
Young at heart.
Which you are.
Yes. Forever. Choose your gay
old
and young
body,
at heart.
But...
Dwayne, please.
Young blood.
Young blood. Okay, you got two now.
Gary?
All I can think of is young and foolish.
Young and foolish.
Why is it wrong to say young and foolish?
Okay.
It was the only answer that I had.
All right. So you've got...
What was
there
it?
Will
who
be
was
no
that, the
editorial
songwriter?
Comment at this stage of the proceedings, please. So you've got young blood, young and foolish, and young at heart. You can choose one of those, Jim, or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Young at heart.
You want to choose young at heart. All right. Okay, that's the one we're looking for. Young at heart. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Is it under the $100 response? Is it? Young and restless.
Oh, that was my answer.
Young and restless.
Right. Almost. It's CBS.
CBS soap opera.
Oh, yeah, it's on at around 1 o'clock or so in the East, yeah. All right, we're looking for young at heart. Here is the $250 response.
Yay!
You've got it. Congratulations. So you got the $250.
I know what it is. I know what it is.
What young, do you think is up there?
Young Mr. Lincoln.
Young blood.
Young blood.
Young blood.
Find out right now. Young blood.
Chinese.
What can I think of that?
Chinese expression.
It's a
Chinese
expression.
Young love.
For
young
years
love.
And years.
Yes. Oh, that's beautiful. It's a great thought. It was a romantic audience we had. All right. Now, Jim, you're up to $350, and now you're going to try for $2,500 to collect. You've got to match one of them. This will have to be an exact match. Which one will it be?
Richard, please.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write, and Jim will
Jim,
face me.
Jim, I've been very unfortunate this week. I hope things turn out all right.
I have faith in you.
Well, just in case you pilot a plane that I'm on with.
All right, here we go. Ready? Puff. blank. That's P-U-F-F blank. Puff blank.
As in
puff. Yes.
So there'll be no mistake.
Yes, puff blank. All right, he's finished. Now, Jim, what answer would you give us that you think would match his? Puff blank.
The magic dragon?
Pray tell, who is Puff the magic dragon?
I remember it from a song. That's about all.
Okay, all right, just want to know what your answer. All right, he says Puff the magic dragon will match you. What do you say?
Well, I say, I guess I'll be traveling by other forms of transportation. I have pastry.
You're going to leave the driving to us and take the bus.
I'm going on the Greyhound. All right.
Okay.
I was better yesterday with Harry Truman.
Yeah. All right, so Jim's got his 350, and he's still the champ. He's going to play another game, so let's meet another player right now. Here comes Carol Tucker. Okay. Carol.
Hi.
You know Jim?
I do.
How's Carol Tucker at this moment?
Well, a little shaky.
No, you're not shaky. What else do you want to tell us about Carol Tucker, aside the fact that she's a little shaky?
Oh, well, she's just fantastic.
Yeah, I think so. Isn't she fantastic?
She sure is.
I'm married to a police officer. I have two lovely children.
Mm-hmm.
I am a school teacher and a housewife.
What do you teach, Carol?
I teach elementary school, fourth and fifth grades.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Is that a difficult job? Are they difficult to manage?
Yes, they are.
They are. There's an honest lady. Okay, let's begin, shall we? Please make a selection, A or B.
B.
You want B. All right. This is for Carol. On the airplane.
Oh, yes.
Stephanie said to Jessica, I don't have much confidence in this airline. I just saw the pilot. And he had a blank sticking out of his pocket. Just saw the pilot and he had a blank sticking out of his pocket.
Oh, I got it. Oh, I just was there. I was hesitant for a minute.
Yes. This, I think this is in... All right. Interesting. Very interesting question, in my opinion. Everybody ready down here? And everybody ready up there? So we'll come over here to Carol Tucker. On the airplane, Stephanie said to Jessica, I don't have much confidence in this airline. I just saw the pilot, and he had a blank sticking out of his pocket.
A bottle of booze.
A bottle of booze. Bottle of booze.
Oh, he had a learner's permit.
A learner's permit. That'd make me nervous, I'll tell you that. What do you say?
I say I think I'm in love. Is that a cute answer?
That's a darling answer.
He's just adorable.
Yes, he is. But I'm not in love with him.
Where would she be in love with him
if his answer was Harry Truman?
We won't go into that, Mary. All right. Anyway, I don't know why she would say that. But I always try to draw on my own personal experience.
Yes.
And I never travel without one, a flask and or a bottle.
There it is. There's one for you, Carol. She's looking for a bottle of booze. What are you offering, Gary?
Nobody's ever called me Mary for years.
You've like, changed.
It's like old times. No, I said a parachute.
A parachute. Okay. Had a parachute sticking out of his pocket. Just saw the pilot, and he had a parachute sticking out of his pocket. That's what he said, although she said bottle of booze. What do you say?
I say bottle, too.
Bottle. Okay, there's Carol's answer. That's two for her. And here we come.
Yes, I'm surprised Mary didn't say bottle as well.
Yeah. Three for you. Hello there.
Hello, Marcia.
Hi, Brett. Jean.
Marcia.
Hello, Mary.
It's not attractive to watch a grown person go to pieces on national television.
No, it isn't.
It isn't. It's never attractive. And
you're not going to
I once heard when the mind goes blank, say banana.
Yes.
Banana. Yeah.
You are going to pieces, my dear.
You know, that
would you get the wet sheets
too.
Ready, please, for Marcia?
And we'll take it. Give that little girl a hug, will you?
Yes. Okay. So that's three for you, and now we've got this. Oh, no, we don't have that for you. I'll put it right back there. And we got this message for you instead.
I love the way they shook it.
Now, we go to second half of round one. Have this question for Jim Lawrence. Carol matched three celebrities in her round. Let's see how he does with his. Hey, Nate, the delicatessen owner, is a fantastic violinist. Oh. But he doesn't use a bow. He strokes the violin with his blank. Everybody plays. Nate, the delicatessen owner. He's a fantastic violinist. But he doesn't use a bow. He strokes the violin with his...
Finished.
Bravo. All right, Jim Lawrence, you are deep in thought. You are thinking deeply. You're getting sleepy. No. Nate, the delicatessen owner, is a fantastic violinist, but he doesn't use a bow. He strokes the violin with his...
Salami.
He says salami.
It's coming to me.
What will you say?
Salami.
Aha! Extrasensory perception is at work, and the psi phenomena is a rampant in the field here. Yeah, hey, lady.
What's the first cousin to a salami?
Bologna.
No! Pastrami, is that a match?
No, pastrami is totally two different things.
I could have told you that when you were wrong.
It's easy for you to say you didn't have that answer.
Yes, I did. What do you say?
My uncle told me I was doing bad on the show.
Your uncle has good taste.
When it comes to salami.
The salami is very good. Okay. So now at this moment, score is 3-2. What do you say?
Oh, I said wiener.
Wiener.
Wiener is sorry about that.
It's not even a small salami. It's
well, it's
totally
sort of a long hot dog. Yeah,
well, no. Couldn't
it's
be done.
A small violin.
Oh, no, you couldn't. You'd have to be Tom Thumb to do that. What do you say?
Salami.
Shalom aleichem. All right.
You hang in with me, Marcia. Remember,
Marcia,
we're roomies.
I've done that.
Now, Marcia, there's nothing to cry about.
No, there isn't.
Marcia, we have to have
there
you back.
There is good
more
news
often.
Tonight, Marcia.
You're terrible.
Remember this moment.
Banana.
Will be proud of you. And he's going to raise your salary for that, too.
Three bananas a week.
Yes. Okay, now we go to round two. Score is 4-3 in favor of the current champ. And Carol, please make a selection.
B.
Here we go. Brett does not play. You do not play. Everybody else does. Hey, Weird Sylvester was thrown out of the department store when they caught him blanking the mannequins.
Weird.
Sylvester the Weirdo. Weird Sylvester was thrown out of the department store when they caught him blanking the mannequins.
I told you, never write your questions from personal experience of the people.
I never wrote this question. All right. Okay. You finished? Everybody ready? I'll take the mic cable if you don't mind, please.
Oh.
All right. Here we go, Carol Tucker. Weird Sylvester was thrown out of the department store when they caught him blanking the mannequins.
Loving the mannequins.
All right. They caught him loving the mannequins. What do you say?
I had something a little more exotic in my undressing.
Undressing the mannequins. That would be a preliminary step, I would think.
Is that a match?
No, that is not a match. Gary, may we see your answer, please?
Wait till they finish laughing over that terrible joke. I said kissing. I think that's a match. That's
kissing
a match.
And loving? How about that? All right. There's one for you, Carol. Now we have one more person to call on, and it's sweet, lovable Marcia.
Marcia, you can do it.
You can do it, Marcia.
Marcia, you know what they say, good dress rehearsal.
Fame is so fleeting.
Well,
short-lived. You know, an all-American person. Dating the mannequin.
Dating. poor Judd is dead.
For okay. one moment, you were our favorite.
Let's see, what do we got here? 4-4, and you're in a good spot. You need one to win, that's all. But we're not going to find out right now if that'll happen. Got to do a little business first. This is it. Okay, here we are.
Certainly
we're going to finish this game. Now, the score is tied at this moment. Jim Lawrence needs one match to win his second game. Let's see if it happens. Jack said, I dreamed I was a circus performer who jumps off a tower into a tank of water. When I woke up, I found I had jumped headfirst into the blank. Three people play. Two. Beg your pardon.
Brett and who?
Brett and Carol.
Hi, Carol.
Hi, Brett.
No socializing. Do your job.
Jumped into the what, honey?
I dreamed I was a circus performer who jumped off a tower into a tank of water. When I woke up, I found I had jumped headfirst into the blank.
We're going to have such fun later on. You're just going to love it.
That's room 1207.
on an 11-story house.
Right. All right.
Oh, wait a minute. It's not that. It's the other.
Well,
no, that's right.
A woman is allowed to change her mind. You didn't.
The woman. The woman okay. is allowed to change
okay,
her mind.
Okay, Jim Lawrence. Jack said, I dreamed I was a circus performer who jumps off a tower into a tank of water. When I woke up, I found I jumped headfirst into the...
John.
Into the John. All right. One John wins a
Why
game for him.
Why is Carol Lawrence, who likes ravioli, going like that?
What's she going? Have to do with
it? Me piace ravioli.
Si brinca.
Into
Jumped
what?
Into the brink.
Jumped into the brink. That's worse than motel. All right, the new record holder up there.
See, why I was going like this, because I said...
So there's another game for you. Carol, I'm sorry it's been such a short meeting for you. I hope you had a few laughs while you were up here.
I had a great time.
Good. All right, Carol Tucker, we've got a gift for you together with our thanks. Goodbye. Now, you know how this goes, so we might as well get right to it, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Valley Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often... Worth 500, 250, and 100, you know all that. Whom do you want here?
Richard, please.
Valley Forge.
Valley Forge.
Carol.
Carol.
Valley of the Dolls.
Valley of the Dolls.
Brett.
Valley of the Jolly Green Giant.
Valley of the Jolly Green Giant. So you've got those three. Valley of the Jolly Green Giant, Valley of the Dolls, and Valley Forge. You want one, or do you want to give us one of your own?
Valley of the Dolls.
I'm going to say Valley of the Dolls. All right. Let's find out where the Valley of the Dolls is. First, may we see the $100 response? Valley of the Jolly Green Giant. Atta girl, Brett.
A likely story.
Yes. We are looking for the Valley of the Dolls, dear friends. Let's see if it's under the $250 response. Valley Forge. All right, last chance.
That was Richard Cancer.
Now let's see if Carol Lawrence's answer comes up as we reveal the $500 response. Valley of the Dolls. Very good. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Got the 500. Now, you're going to have a go at 5,000. Which one do you want to try and match?
Carol.
Okay, Carol, you get ready to write. Here is the $5,000 question. Face me, if you please. 12 o'clock blank. 12 o'clock blank. Okay, Carol's finished now. What do you say to that? 12 o'clock blank.
Noon.
12 o'clock noon? And you're a pilot? May we see your answer, please?
12 o'clock high.
12 o'clock high. He thought of it and didn't do it. Oh, that's too bad.
He's a pilot.
Yeah, he is a pilot, too. Oh, boy. Crossed his mind, he rejected it. Okay, you got $950, Jim. Stand by now. Here is a message for you. Oh, hello there. Oh, listen, just time to say goodbye here. Oh, thank you from the bottom of my black old heart.
Gene,
you were
thank
splendid.
You.
Well, thank
you. Oh, I love your birds of paradise.
Thank you.
May
those
the bird of paradise.
Marcia, I'll never forget this moment. I hope you'll come back often and make a fool of yourself over and over again.
Thank you, Gene. I'll certainly try.
Coming up next.
Listen, you want to know who's going to be here next time we get together? I'm going to tell you right now.
Avery Schreiber, Brett Summer, Gary Burghoff, Chris Stewart, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch.
Gene Rayburn in Match Game 75. Join us next time. Bye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.